Well, ABC News Entertainment contributor Chris Connelly joining me now to talk about this morning's Oscar nominations. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
You know, Chris, around here, we are very excited about the two of the Best Picture nominees because, well, they were shot here. Don't Look Up was filmed in and around Boston, and Coda was shot in a set here as well. What do you think of the chances of any of those films bringing home an Oscar?
I think Coda in particular is really a phenomenon. I mean, this is a movie that really people watched, you know, on its streaming service, Apple, and it's a movie with, you know, very few big stars, and people just love that movie. And when they see it, they tell other people to watch it. And it's exciting that Troy Kotsur has been now the first deaf male actor ever to get an Oscar nomination. So there's nothing but excitement connected to that movie right now. And in terms of Boston, maybe it makes up for the fact that for The Tender Bar, Ben Affleck was overlooked in supporting actor.
Yeah, I think it definitely makes up for sure. If you had to pick, though, overall for an early favorite for Best Picture, what would your choice be?
I see it as a two or three picture race, like something like West Side Story, Belfast, and The Power of the Dog. I see all those as potential contenders, but I think it's a pretty wide open race at this point anyway.
So far, when you look at the list of who has been nominated, what films have been nominated, what are your thoughts on any of the snubs? A lot of folks were thinking they were going to see Lady Gaga up there, Ruth Negga up there. Not on the list.
Yeah, I was surprised by Ruth Negga. I thought she was phenomenal in Passing, and that movie turned out to be overlooked by the Oscars. And I think that's a shame. I think Dame Judi Dench got her nomination, and she's great, but I would have preferred to see Ruth Negga in there. And I was sorry that Jennifer Hudson didn't get picked for, you know, her Aretha Franklin bio, Respect, which I thought was phenomenal. But I'm happy that Kristen Stewart's in there for playing Princess Diana in Spencer. It's not like The Crown. It's not your typical look at what Princess Diana was. It's filtered through the unique sensibility of Kristen Stewart that we've seen and enjoyed in so many movies, and I'm delighted that she's in the Oscar mix this year.
Yeah, definitely a different kind of role for her. But let's talk about actresses in general for Best Actress category. Let me list the names. We have Jessica Chastain, Olivia Colman, Kristen Stewart, Nicole Kidman, and Penelope Cruz. Who's the leading contender right now?
That's a really good question because, you know, I think when Kristen Stewart was seen as a more obvious nominee, she was seen as the favorite, you know, just because it felt like it was her time. She was taking on a new and large challenge and giving it her all. Some of these other people you mentioned, they've won Oscars. Penelope's won one, Nicole's won one, Olivia's won one. So who is Oscar feeling like it's their turn or who is deserving? That one I think is wide open, but I think Kristen Stewart, because she's nominated, is back in that category and back in the conversation. And if I had to bet, I would bet on her.
Huh. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Let's talk about Best Actor nominees now, because I think a lot of folks are curious about this one. Andrew Garfield, Benedict Cumberbatch, Javier Bardem, Denzel Washington, and Will Smith. Who's the favorite here?
Yeah, it's packed. I mean, it's just packed. Those guys are great. Some of them have Oscars of their own. Some of them have more than one Oscar. Denzel, like, resets the bar every time he does anything, and now he's doing Shakespeare for Joel Cohn. So how much better can it get? But I think the likely favorite is Will Smith for King Richard. I think he's likely to win, and I think he's going to be a very popular winner as well.
I'm glad to hear you say that, because I love that film, King Richard. It was worth watching more than once, I would say. All right, Chris Connelly, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate what you had to say, and we're looking forward to seeing who wins it all.